Nerve entrapment in hand, or carpal tunnel syndrome with its more scientific name, affects a considerable part of the population. The incidence is up to 5%. You can guess that its rate is much higher in older ages. The good news is that there will be enough time to seek treatment since it is a disease that progresses very slowly. You may be wondering if it leaves a permanent disability. Or should you accept this problem and go on with your life? Which treatment methods work? In this video, you will find answers to these questions. Hello, I am Dr. Gürkan. In this video, you will find information about carpal tunnel syndrome from the perspective of an orthopedic surgeon. Over the age of 50 to 55, carpal tunnel syndrome is manifested by numbness in the fingers, tingling, and loss of strength. As it progresses, the patient wakes up at night to the morning with numbness and pain in hand. In the later stages, the pain may extend to the shoulder. Very slowly, complaints increase over the years. Although different treatment methods provide short-term well-being, permanent treatment is surgery. The median nerve carries the sensation of the first three fingers plus half of the ring finger. The nerves from both sides of these fingers combine to form the median nerve. It travels to the forearm through an anatomical space called the carpal tunnel, with the other nine tendons towards the wrist. The front part of this space is covered and protected with a thick sheath of fibrous tissue, while wrist bones form the other portion. By aging, there will be a decrease in the volume of this canal. Although the cause for this decrease of 70% is unknown, degeneration and age-related deformation in carpal bones may be causing this. For some patients, the canal volume may have decreased because of the fractures around the wrist that were not healed with a perfect configuration. Sometimes, the thickening of the synovial membrane lining inside of this canal with diseases such as rheumatoid arthritis can cause a decrease in the volume of the canal. Obesity, hypothyroidism due to impaired functioning of the thyroid gland, and kidney failure are other risk factors. It is three times more common in women. There is an increased susceptibility to carpal tunnel syndrome in diabetes. The reason is most likely due to impaired nerve function in diabetic patients. Due to the hand's position, nerve compression symptoms appear more quickly in those who use the mouse for a long time in a day. For any reason, signs of carpal tunnel syndrome may occur temporarily in those who use crutches or walkers, or individuals who ride long-distance bicycles. When it is on one side, there is a 73% likelihood of being on the other. It is also thought to have a genetic predisposition. The progression of the disorder takes 5 to 10 years very slowly. Complaints that may take weeks initially may resolve spontaneously after a while. There are healthy periods without pain for months, and sometimes years. Over the years, complaints increase, and periods of attacks become longer. The patient wakes up with numbness in the fingers of the hand early in the morning or at midnight. Although, theoretically, numbness is expected in the first four fingers, patients cannot always make this distinction and express tingling and numbness in all their fingers. In their advanced periods, they wake up at night and shake their hands with pain that can go up to the elbow and shoulder. In patients whose treatment is delayed, weakening and atrophy in the small muscles on the thumb side of the hand may occur. Having these complaints and a typical physical examination may be sufficient to make the diagnosis. When pressure is applied to the surface of the carpal tunnel during the physical examination, the patient describes the feeling of numbness in the fingers, which usually starts within 10 to 15 seconds. Although it is often recommended that diagnosis and treatment can be planned with examinations and complaints, physicians may order an electrodiagnostic nerve test, known as electromyography or EMG with the initials, to confirm the diagnosis. This test is generally applied and reported in neurology clinics and supports the diagnosis. When patients' complaints increase, they request treatment. In the early period, wrist braces regress complaints for a while. Laser and ultrasound can be used in the non-surgical treatment of carpal tunnel syndrome. Steroid injections into the carpal canal can also temporarily resolve complaints. Since patients mostly expect permanent treatment, these methods do not satisfy them. As the disease progresses, only short-term relief of complaints is achieved with these treatment methods. Permanent treatment of the disease is surgery. During the surgery, the tight and thickened fibrous sheath in front of the carpal tunnel is released. Orthopedic surgeons, hand surgeons, or neurosurgeons may perform this surgery in different parts of the world. The operation is usually completed within 15 to 20 minutes. It is a simple surgical procedure achieved with local or short-term general anesthesia. Carpal tunnel release surgery is a daily procedure. Staying in the hospital after the surgery is unnecessary, and the patient goes home in a few hours. After a few days of changing the dressing, in 1 or 2 weeks, the wound can be left open. The day after the operation, the pain disappears. The night pains before the surgery ultimately improve and never come again. If there are stitches, they can be removed within 15 days. The patient can use his hand while eating, using a pen or computer the next day of the surgery. It is helpful to wait 2 to 3 weeks to drive a car and 6 weeks for hard work, such as washing dishes and gardening. Due to an operation performed on the palm, it can take up to 3 months to gain full performance for people who work using their hands. If a patient postpones the surgery for 10 to 15 years, the pressure on the nerve will make irreversible changes. The muscle atrophy on the thumb side of the hand do not recover. The numbness of the fingertips does not improve ultimately. Still, a satisfactory result obtains even in this patient, as the patient's night pain disappears. There are no postoperative recurrences expected if the surgery was made successfully. The reproduction of complaints is due to insufficient release. Infection is sporadic, and oral antibiotics are sufficient if it develops. Endoscopic surgery from small incisions is also an option in carpal tunnel syndrome. As a surgeon, I performed endoscopic surgery for a while. I can say that it does not have an advantage over open surgery. Moreover, complications such as nerve injury, insufficient release, and failure to improve complaints may also be high for surgeons with little experience in endoscopic surgery. If you plan to have endoscopic treatment, it is essential that you choose an experienced clinic and physician in this regard. As a result, don't worry about surgical treatment when carpal tunnel syndrome develops. You can be sure that the outcome of the surgery will be excellent. Moreover, remember that when you delay treatment, other health problems will develop over the years, and you will have to deal with other problems as well. As long as problems arise, we should be able to solve them and move on with our lives. Remember to subscribe and hit the like button so you don't miss my videos with orthopedics and sports content. May you have active days when your face is always smiling.